我们晓得台湾的前途是台日美，还有中国的这个国际关系会决定，希望印度也慢慢可以参加这个国际关系的发展的话，我们台湾的前途就会决定在前。那么今天我们就听到这个从美国分析，还有到日本分析，那么这些呢观点我们慢慢来看，台湾到最后的结论就是台湾自己要怎么样，也是关系最大。那么我们现在剩下还有一点时间呢，我们就请这个毛利摩夫先生还有黄立邦先生都好，好，嗨，嗨，都。
Okay, well, time is very short. I just would like to make just one point. Some people may know that Abe administration established an advisory group to review the interpretation of constitution in security policy. And this group still continue to discuss, but my guess is that this advisory group will make a very strong and clear recommendation to the Prime Minister in the next 2 or 3 months to allow Japan to exercise the right of self-defense and also participation to the collective security as the basic right of nation-state under the international law. Also, both the U.S. and Japan will make agree on to review the U.S.-Japan Defense Cooperation Guideline in the next 1 or 1.5 years. Under the condition that Japan will be able to exercise the right of self-defense. In that sense, I think if everything is going on well, we may reinforce roles and mission and capabilities under the U.S. Japan Cooperation Guideline on the defense area in order to supplement the United States roles and mission in this area. But we need a legislation in order to implement this guideline and also recommendation also official statement which based on the recommendation by our advisory group sometime next year including self-defense law and also legislation on the contingency surrounding Japan which is in Japan also, I think this element will affect seriously the outcome of defense outline program and the midterm defense plan, which is, will be concluded by the end of this year by the Security Council of Cabinet meeting in Tokyo. That means that next 1 year, we are facing a very serious turning point for the security policy, not only for US Japan, both US Japan countries, also our neighboring countries such as OK or Taiwan and some other friendly countries in the Asian Pacific. My guess is that China and South Korea may make some reservation on the future direction of our security policy in this sense. But most important agenda is how much we discuss with the United States so that the United States really understands what kind of contribution we should and what kind of roles and mission of to share with United States for the peace and security in East Asia. I think this is the most important security contribution for the peace and security in the region. That is my
concern. 我想补充一句话，关于台湾的法治的问题，我以前在台湾大学跟同学讨论过这个问题，他看来觉得这个小日本在批判我们台湾人，他看来觉得日本的殖民很高，台湾人不好。其实并没有这样子，法治不是那样的考虑的问题。比如说在日本有很多不好的人反思着黑道，因为我的以前的公司是新闻记者，我当然知道，可是日本人他还遵守比如说交通法规，为什么？因为已经有社会规范的累积，对于社会这是历史的结果，历史时间经过很多时间的累积的结果，我本人并没有贡献，可是在日本黑道也遵守限度对方，这是最基本的 infrastructure。 那台湾是什么？对，我觉得台湾历史还不够，时间还不够，这样而已。台湾是逃国，所以将来五十年一百年后的台湾当然有我社会的累积，规范的累积。我这样回答。对于中国也，我想就一样的事，一样的看法。不是他们不是逃国，社会的安定继续在那大陆，可能是很困难的事。换台湾，我的看法是非常的 positive。一百年、两百年后。我非常不是，这个法治的问题不是那么考虑的问题，不好意思，我只要是这样子，谢谢。
我们刚好是二十分钟，所以我们学习这个陈峰山、陈唐山那个秘闻，我们就把元首时间到这里，我们就结束，谢谢大家。
Thank you, everyone.